Hi, I'm Anna Warakan, and I just graduated from the St. Vincent Girls High School. My favorite book genre is probably psychological or mystery. Today, I'll be reading an original piece that I wrote in grade 6, entitled A Night to Remember. I hope you enjoy it. It was the end of a very long week at school, and I was tired of all the assignments. I was exhausted, and my mom was too. She had sore feet from the long hours at work, and she just wanted to take a quick shower. Tonight was a night that mom and I relaxed, watched a movie, ate popcorn, and enjoyed the night while it lasted. Mom was quick to remind me to lock the kitchen door before she retreated to the shower. But at that moment, my best friend Helena called. We were planning on going to the beach the following day, and she wanted to give me all the details. Mom emerged 10 minutes later, and we were deciding on a movie. We finally selected one that we could both agree on, Heaven is for Real. As the lights were off, I cuddled next to my mom, and she stroked my hair. Moments later, we gasped, as there was a loud bang coming from the kitchen. And suddenly, two dark silhouettes appeared out of nowhere. At that moment, I realized my error, and I saw my entire life flash before me. I was petrified. One of the robbers clutched my mom's neck and told her to shut up as she was about to scream. He was big, burly, and wore a mask to conceal his identity. The other robber held me tightly and clasped his coarse hand over my mouth. I struggled to get away from his grip, but he threatened that we would both be killed if we did not remain silent. The next instant, Mom and I were tied up with the ropes and gagged. I felt horrible to see my mom with panic-stricken eyes, and I started to cry. It was my fault that this happened to us, because of me not following my mom's instruction. We were then pushed into the hallway closet, and I overheard the men laugh about how easy it was to get into the house. Since we both could not talk, move, or even see because of the dark room, I relied on my hearing skills. I heard footsteps going back and forth many times, and soon realized that we were being robbed of everything. I heard the footsteps go past us once again, this time in the direction of the stairs. I prayed to God to get us out of this horrendous situation, that our lives be spared. I struggled one last time against the ropes and prayed and begged for forgiveness for not locking that kitchen door. Miraculously, the ropes got loose. I was shocked and couldn't believe my luck. My heart palpitated out of my chest. I fumbled in the dark to untie my mom. We were both thinking the same thing as mom gently squeezed my hand. We quietly tiptoed out of the closet and out the front door. Down the street, we ran for dear life and nothing could stop us. Before we knew it, we were standing in front of a policeman, recounting our experience with the robbers. We were told to remain at the station as two patrol cars were dispatched to our home. I was awoken the next day by my mom, who tiredly informed me that our robbers were apprehended an hour ago as they were trying to sell our household items. She said that they would be incarcerated for a very long time, and I was deeply relieved. Boy, what a night to remember. My final message to all of you is that I want to encourage you to read and write, because these skills will follow you for the rest of your life, and they will impact you in one way or the other.